this is Kenneth Barber. We are starting a new series today on spiritual warfare. Today is the first lesson, Victory in the Battle. Amen. We're going to be coming from 1 Samuel chapter 17 and 45. Come in the name of the Lord. Lord, we thank you for giving us knowledge, wisdom, and understanding beyond our years, that we may be of service unto you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 45. Then said David to the Philistine, Thou comest to me with the sword and with the spear and with the shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou defilest. Who's talking here? David. He's talking to Goliath. Amen? Hallelujah. He's talking to Goliath. He's saying, You uncircumcised Philistine, I have come here today to feed your carcass to the fowl of the air. Let's read verse 46. Let's go to read verse 46. One moment, let me pull that up real quick. Thank you, Jesus. First Samuel 17. Thank you, Jesus. Here we are. This day, just like as I said, this day the Lord will deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee and take thine head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host to the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air and to the wild beasts of the earth, and all the earth shall may know that there is a God in Israel. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your loving kindness and your mercy does endure forever. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Mercies are good every morning, renewed every morning. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So when the world is against us, it's not time to tuck tail and run. Amen. Jesus has given us the authority and the power through the Holy Spirit to attack the enemy. We have to do everything. We have everything in our hands and in our hearts. All we have to do is believe and choose to understand that what God has given us, that there's no limit to what we can achieve in this life. Amen. So today, what does this scripture mean to me? This means to me that God is going to take care of our trouble. And sometimes he uses us to be the mouthpiece and the hands and feet extended to do it. Amen. How do I feel that I have no authority, or how do I see that I have no authority? How do I feel? Sometimes feelings can get in the way. Amen. How do I feel that I have no authority? That's the question. So today I want you to understand, you have the authority in Christ. Amen. You are a believer in him. You are his mouthpiece. You are his hands and feet extended. You are what God has called you to be and who you are and whose you are. You are a priest of your household. You are a royal priesthood. You are a Levite. You are a person of interest and a person of power in the authority of Christ. Amen. How can I face Goliath? To me, that question is head on. I'm going to take everything that I have learned, everything that I've been taught, everything that I have absorbed from my pastor or for other people that have ministered and breathed into me, and things that God himself has breathed into my spirit, man. All those things are what you come to rely on when you're talking about going through something in faith. Amen. How can I defeat Goliath? It's real simple. It's obedience, amen? Obedience to what God has called you to do. Who will help me defeat him? The Holy Spirit, just like we just talked about. Who will help me defeat him? The blood of the Lamb and the word of his testimony, amen? What happens in verse 46 in the same chapter? We just read that. He came, he said, I'm going to feed your carcass to the fowl of the air after I cut your head off. He was bold, was he not? Amen. So did David lose or win the battle? I believe he won the battle because he was still alive and Goliath was headless and dead on the ground. Amen. What will I take from this lesson? Today I take for this lesson that God is wonderful, even in adversity, what's happening around us. Amen. That we have the authority and the audacity to proclaim the word of God with boldness, with dominion, and with power. What are all those things come from? Being a child of God, having salvation, being filled with the Holy Spirit, being with knowledge, wisdom, and understanding beyond your years. What do I mean by that, Brother Barber? What I mean by that is God is an undoing you from on high here while reading his word in here in our heart. And then when it comes out in power. Amen. And then you can be instant in season and out of season, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. How do I apply what I've learned? It's a tough question. But today, it's a faith walk. You walk every day out. Every day out to its fullest. Amen. So God bless you. I hope you got something out of this short devotion today. And this is just one of 15. Matthew chapter 4 and verse 4. And 2 Corinthians 10 and 4. And the last scripture today is Revelations 12 and 11. Read those after you get done with the lesson today. May God bless you. May God richly bless you. God bless you. Shalom. Peace be unto you. Good morning. How is everybody doing today? I just wanted to come on and let you know about Barber Family Ministries Resources Center. We have four different platforms that we love to have you come out and be a part virtually. Barber Family Ministries webpage. And I just wanted to give you a preview of what we're talking about this morning. You can see all of our live services online. And we are still in the planning phases of planning our next conference. But I do want to let you know that we are planning on recording those live. And that will be in September of this year. But I want to give you an opportunity to see what's going on today. And we are doing live Zoom revival with a bunch of different ministers. I've been loving it. It's been awesome, been fun. And but let's go back to their virtual ministry here. So as you see on your screen now, this is our homepage for Barber Family Ministries. And we use Wix for our provider. It's a free account. You can do that yourself. And this is taking many man hours to taken care of. But I loved it. And you can see past online services and worship sets that we've done in the last week and this week. And then other special things. So, like, if you want to know or come back and see, oh, I love that song you sing, or I love that song that Elise does, or some special thing that we've done during a service live or here in production and at our studios, you'll find it here, a link to our YouTube page. All right, and then we have worship and so forth. All those kinds of things you can be found on our website, And we also have, oh, here we go. It's live video now. Excuse me. And we have a Facebook page. So love for y'all to come out and be a part of that. Like our page. All of our live stuff is there. All the things that we're doing here currently or done in the past, I'll be there for your enjoyment, your perusal. And we also have our YouTube page. This is our main page. All right. And love for y'all to come out and be a part. That's me talking about the Zoom revival that we're doing currently. And we also have the playlist. So that's broken down into online services, worship time, special covered music, and so forth. And we also have our past conferences that we've done recorded there for your perusal. And last but not least, we have our Twitter page. So if you'd like to come out and be a part of that, I try to when I'm in the production studio here in our home to do all preaching online live through Periscope, which directly feeds Twitter. So if you'd like to come out and be a part, love to have you. Love to be with you in service. If you'd love to come out and be a part, if you'd like us to come out physically when we are past this craziness that's going on right now, this pandemic, we would love to come out and be a part with your service, preach, teach, play, sing. We also do, on occasion, dramas, and my wife also does interpretive dance, as well as interpretive worship through sign language. So if you'd like to come us to come out to be a part of your service, or if you'd like to be a part of our service online, just give me a shout. You can talk to me Twitter, Facebook, or leave a comment or message through YouTube, and we'd love to have you. God bless you. Have a wonderful day, and hear from Barber Family Ministries. Shalom, peace be unto you.